Good morning and welcome to Grain TV. It's September 19, 2012. To my left is Logan Burgess and I'm Brock Chimbino. The grains are once again trading positive after a slight sell-off yesterday. Let's turn it over to Fire Tip to see what's happening in Chicago. As you can see here, corn, soybeans, and wheat all trading positive. Soybeans, once again, the leader to the upside.
Yeah, Brock, you know, the dollar index is trading a little bit lower here today. That should support the grains as we move forward. It's kind of interesting to see that dollar index making a pullback here today. This morning, we actually added the Japanese yen to our trading matrix. And in the overnight session, the Japanese Central Bank did announce plans for a round of quantitative easing. You'd expect if the Japanese are printing more money, that should devalue the yen with respect to the dollar. So that's interesting to see here. It looks like their round of quantitative easing is not quite as effective as what they'd like in the early going. We'll have to see how it goes, obviously, because the Japanese are large importers of U.S. corn and soybeans. If we turn our attention to crude oil here, trading down about $3 a barrel now on expectations for Saudi Arabia to increase output over the next couple months. But really, turning back to grains here, the big story right now is that after several days of sharp selling, it looks like we're catching some traction.
Yeah, it looks like on the soybean daily chart that we're looking at here, soybeans are catching a little bit of a bid around that 1645 area. We are slightly positive today. Yesterday, throughout the day session, we sold lower, ending the day about down about 29 or 30 on soybeans. But it does look like that top end of that range that we were trading in from late July to late August actually is providing support right now at this time. Right now we're fighting to get over that 50-day moving average, so we're going to have to keep our eyes on that as we move forward throughout the day.
Certainly. You know, one thing that's going to weigh on grains a little bit here, we did just get a new report out from Reuters here. They took a poll of 14 analysts. Right here we kind of break down the average of those analyst guess. As you can see here, the analyst's average guess for corn yield out of this crop is 121 bushels per acre, lower than what we saw come out in the USDA's report on September 10th. Turning our attention to soybeans here is actually higher than what the USDA saw or reported on that September 10th report. 35.85 bushels per acre is now what analysts are kind of expecting out of this crop. As we turn our attention here to production, as you can see, corn 10.42 billion bushels, lower than what the USDA had this crop pegged at in their September 10th report at 10.73 bushels. And the thing that's going to catch some attention here is as a result of a higher yield expectation, we're now seeing a 2.67 billion bushels out of this soybean crop, higher than what we saw out of the USDA's report. We'll have to keep an eye on that. That should pressure the soybean complex a little bit. That certainly might have been factored into our sell-off here that we saw over the last 3 days. But one more thing that might be weighing on this complex here is harvest pressure. How's weather looking for harvest, Brock?
Yeah, it looks like the next 6 to 10 days we are looking pretty good as far as precipitation is concerned. It looks like it's going to be fairly dry. Combines are rolling at a record pace on corn, 26% complete on corn as of Monday, 10% complete on soybeans, so I do anticipate those numbers to increase quite a bit as we get next Monday's crop progress report. And temperature outlook, looking a little bit lower than what we should be for this time of year, but I don't think that's going to really have an effect on what the combines are doing. We're going to be moving quickly through this harvest pace, so I anticipate the numbers to be quite large on Monday, next Monday.
Certainly. Well, we'll keep you updated on this market as it trades live on Twitter, at Grain TV is where you can find us. That wraps up our show here for Wednesday morning. Thanks a lot for joining us. Join us tomorrow morning for the Export Sales Report.